at least $1 million in wood. Oh, I'd have to do any wedging. Wow. Look how big this pile is. It's huge. Okay, so we are expanding the drop zones for the helicopter to drop the wood. You're partway down the mountain, and we get a huge pile of wood. Huge pile. Ground's way down there. Look at that, that's ground. Another big pile of wood. I'll show you the rest of it. They're just getting started. Okay, here it is. We're on a road right now, an old logging road. And just underneath this, or just over there, there is a junction, a big flat area here, a big pullout. The wood's all buried on this pullout here. There's a big log. Look how big this pile is. It's huge. That's a huge pile. Man. There must be a few million dollars in wood in here. At least $1 million in wood. There's so much wood. All fir. Look at that. All fir. Wow. We just opened this up. We're fogged out, eh? That's why we're here. We're fogged out. See all that fog there? A few guys finishing up. Yeah, and then you can see this one here. It's got this pink piece of paper stapled to them. Each, like a single paper stapled means one thing. A double stapled two pink squares means something else. I forget what they mean. I think a double means full weight, like a max weight piece. I don't remember. But yeah, there's a lot here. Let's go over here. My partner's just cutting trail again. He's cutting trail back out to the other side of the road over there. Like, look at all this. Look at all this wood. Look, way down there. This is like one satellite block. Like, this is just one little section of a little, or this is one little block. And he did a satellite block first, and this is all that wood. Satellite block just means it's just a little block, a little section. There's so much more wood to go. Oh man, this is only one drop zone. It's a small one too. And then the pile goes way over there. Like, I'm 20 feet up right now. Gotta be careful where I walk, because some of these logs, like this big 6'3", this probably weighs 10,000 pounds. It's probably a max weight. It's like, it's shaking pretty good. It's moving pretty good. I could probably get it to roll. But yeah, I'm like, maybe 20 feet up. A lot of wood. Okay, I gotta get going here. Look, there's ground way down there. Underneath that log, and it's stacked up on top of each other, all the way up. Oh man. Look at this one. They flew out the whole roots and everything. It's probably a blowdown or something. They flew the whole thing out. Okay, so we're back on the hill. What time is it? Yeah, just about noon. So we've got a couple hours on the hill today because we're fogged out this morning. I'll try and get a shot of that log pile from the chopper at the end of the day to see how big it is. So this is what I'm working on. I've already prepped the area. I fell a few trees already. I think I'm gonna have to shave a stump down. Yeah, I'll show you. Yeah, so I wanna put it right down in here. It's gonna hit hard. There's nothing I can do about it. I think I might shave that one down. That's what I'm gonna do. Do that one first, and then I'll start in the undercut.
Thank you. cut out the middle, but that's it. Actually, I might just double check here, because I think this is going to be a lot of wedging. Is that even a big enough undercut? There you go. See right there. Straight up. Yeah, that's not good enough. I'm going to make it a little bigger. Make it a little bigger. Well, let me just check this over here. So make it too small, then I'm going to be wedging my guts out for a long time just to get the tip over. Okay, so I took a little bit more. I went a little bit far on the bottom cut, but it's just like quarter inch is nothing much. It's not gonna change anything. Okay, go with this so you can see. A little bit bigger now. I'll cut this one up now because it's limb tied. Look, you can see this. Limb tied a bit there, so at least I think it is. And then I'll shorten it back up.
Sorry about that. I grabbed the tripod and it shifted there on me. So I should have grabbed the camera, not the tripod. So that's why I jerked it. But I saved right out, eh? It rolled a long ways down there. I saved right out. Oh, I'm zoomed in. There we go, that's a little better. Oh, I didn't have to do any wedging. Oh man, I was getting ready for a big wedge-a-thon. See, it pays to take the time to make sure your undercut is big enough, because if I didn't make the undercut bigger, I probably would have been wedging my guts out for 10 minutes. So it definitely pays to make sure your undercut's big enough. Oh man, I'll show you guys again. Way down there, look at it, way down there. Wow. It's a good thing I shaved that stump down right there. I'm not sure. Maybe it didn't really help much because it landed right there. Right, there's the bark. Peeled off the bark. So probably hit here and bounced over that. I'd have to watch the replay there, but. Oh. All right, gotcha, thank you. There's my partner chicken on me. Yeah, undercut's a bit big. But man, it was worth it. See, I cut out the middle there. Yeah, no, it was looking good. Good. Wow, that was fun. That was all really fun. The saw's cutting really good too. Okay, so what's next is got a couple of these trees here. You see there's a ribbon there along the rock face, and it goes up, it gets that fir over there, then it goes up on that rock up there, gets that fir, then goes over. So I don't have a whole lot left. I gotta go and ribbon out a snag after.
thought it'd go down easier than that. Man, the sun, or not the sun, the wind, blowing the sawdust right in my face. It's blowing right up the hill. It's fine fir bark, fir sawdust. Get my eyes. It's like at least 20 feet down, 20 to 30 feet. Not 20 feet. Down there, it's way down. There's a rock ledge here. Yeah, I go buck that one. That one should fly full length. I'll go buck that one there. Yeah. Let's see if there's another one I can get. Get a couple tops maybe. Yeah. I didn't move. I thought the butt would drop and the top would go way up in the air.